Hey there, Jonathan Sports. First preseason game versus the Jets is in the books. Hold that L. Hold that L, Giants fans. You know, I honestly don't give two shits about wins or losses in the preseason game. Honestly, I wouldn't feel any different if we won. But what I am a little disappointed in is just not seeing a few key players. At least we know they won't get hurt. We did get to see some starters. Both nose tackles were in there. Danny Shelton, he had a nice, sweet, you know, run stop on a third down. Austin Johnson had a key pressure up the gut on a third down. So these guys played and showed up. I guess that's to be expected. Tate Crowder got in the mix a little bit with the first unit. Rodarius Williams gave up a couple catches in the first quarter, first couple drives. They weren't bad plays, I'll say that. Receivers just made a better play. Now, Rodarius did tighten up later in the game and played better, and I thought he was okay. For never seeing him before, I didn't quite know what to expect. I don't know, from the way the reports were coming out, like, he was going to be Darrell Revis, but I thought he was okay. He looked good. You know, he's definitely has some pop. He definitely has some speed. So, but he did recover a fumble late in the fourth quarter and almost had a touchdown. The quarterback just got a hand on him. And that fumble was forced by Quincy Wilson. He looks okay, too. Quincy Wilson, not bad. Has, like, a depth. If they're going to keep maybe a fifth safety on the team, not bad. He's young. All the units, all the corners played good. So, I got no complaints. Now, the first team offense was not good. I thought the O-line was a mixed bag. They didn't look awful. I mean, Matt Parrott gave up a sack that was ugly. That sucked. I'm a believer in Matt Parrott, though. I think he's going to get this thing turned around. This is the time to get them kind of sacks out of your system, though. Booker was meh. I think it was the second drive, and Corey Clement looked very good. He came in, and he looked like he gave the offense a boost, and he just looked quicker, faster, but then he fucking fumbled down inside the goal line. And it was a buzzkill, man. You know, he can't do that. And I had flashbacks of Shane Vereen. You guys, if you're a little bit older, you know what I'm talking about. Like, third down, running back, you know, and every time he goes on the field, you get a little extra oof. But when you start him, he fumbles the ball, so you can't trust him. So, take away the fumble, and Clement looked like the best running back on the team, in my opinion. Obviously, Saquon's not out there, but there really wasn't much going on early, though, in this game. One really nice catch by David Sills. You know, he looked okay. At the end of the game, he had a chance for a couple, you know, a couple nice catches, and Ballantyne knocked them down. We all know Corey Ballantyne is an all-pro cornerback in the preseason. Unfortunately, when the games count, the dude can't even stay on his feet. He's just falling over. I don't know why some players are like that, but it is what it is. Just my observation, number 45, Mondre Harper, was all over the place. But the first unit in the beginning, I saw him like lining up at outside linebacker. And then as the game went on, I saw him at, you know, slot corner. I saw him lining up safety. He was even playing like outside cornerback on the sideline. So it seems like he's a versatile guy. And because of that, you know, maybe he's got a chance, like an outside chance of making this roster. So let's see. Zeez Ojulari came in for, I think it was just one drive, maybe the second drive of the defense. And he lined up against Mekhi Becton. I thought he was going to get dominated, but yeah, she looked good. Like, he is slippery, man. And he was getting back to a little bit of trouble in the run game, which it surprised me. You know, I got to just be honest about it. I didn't see that coming. But that's a good sign. If he's competing with Becton, snap one right off the bat. Like, and he also had a pretty decent pass rush as well. Like, he didn't get a sack, but he got a nice pressure. He got good pushing. He was pushing Becton back a little bit. So I'm good where Ojulari is at power-wise so far. I was pleasantly surprised. That's good for us. Second, third quarters were just snooze fast, man. Like, a whole lot of nothing. Fourth quarter picked up a little bit. You know, the biggest play came from that Sandro Blatzgummer, 48 yards, right up the right sideline. I believe it was from like 2 or 3 yard line. So I'm very happy for Sandro. He's got a really cool story. If you're interested, I have a whole video on him. You know, he came over from Austria as one of them international players, which the NFL, by the way, I saw this, I read this in an article. The NFL might allow the international players to be on the team, the 53-man roster, and not officially take a spot or something. It was something like that. I just read something about it. Anyways, that was a nice run by Sandro. Congratulations. He had to feel good. I know Saquon was over there, you know, having a good time with him. Awesome. Now, the best play of the game was, of course, the Damian Willis touchdown, who weirds me the fuck out with the number 87 jersey. But I thought the play was really made by the quarterback, Clayton Thorson. He was climbing the pocket, you know, and buying a little bit of extra time. You know, it really felt like no one was getting open at all in this game and in certain spots and moments. I guess preseason, but it was just a copy and paste from last season, the offense. So, I don't know. As a whole, just the offense was not where I wanted it to be. I don't know. It's just not good enough. I know it's preseason, and coaches are going to keep it vanilla, but all, you know, kind of all we've ever seen from this offense is vanilla, so a little worrisome. There better be more plays week one of the regular season. I like a few of the run plays, as usual, with Garrett's offense. He's got some nice, you know, in the guards pole, and they're nice. Pretty basic, though. I mean, they just work. They're just run plays that work. I liked the reverse play. That was really nice, but we saw that all last year. That's about it, other than just a couple deep balls at David Sills and that one touchdown. I thought the Giants should have run more, but I get that it's preseason. You want to get some passes on tape, you know, plenty of passes, different guys, so they have some stuff to work on, but frustrating, man. It was a little frustrating at one point for me. But to get off that mindset, I just remembered a good thing before I forget. It was a great play made by Willie Henry right before the 2-minute warning. Like the, I can't remember if the Jets were going to run. I know the Jets were going to run the timeout, but I can't remember if it was before or after the 2-minute warning. But it was a huge run stop right at the end to get the ball back, to give the offense a chance. I mean, of course, the Jets punt. Next play by the Giants offense is a fucking safety and the game's over. Of course. But that was just a nice run stop, and that situation was a hell of a play. And I did say when Willie Henry was brought over here that he had an outside chance of making the back end of this roster, and I stick by that. I think he's seen why. But for Patrick Graham, that was a perfect blitz call at the right time to at least give our offense a chance for one play. Sorry, I know people don't like laughing. Oh, one more side note. Here we go. I keep remembering things. Carter Coughlin did have moments where he flashed for me. And him and Afidi had some nice run stops together at one point. You know, they both look pretty good. Carter looks natural at middle linebacker. He was up and down. I remember the Denzel Mims was in at the end of the game. He had like a ridiculous, like broke like 8 tackles because everybody's trying to punch the ball out. Fuck that. Just make the tackle. Just get the guy down. Because what ended up happening is he pushed an extra 5-6 yards, got the first down, and that was the Jets' touchdown in the game. And that's why they fucking lost. So the offense was blah. You know, you're going to hear people pulling the alarms already. It's too early. You know, let them people be hyperbolic. You know, the whole team, maybe 4 or 5 players will be started this week one of the season, other than outside of the O-line. The starting O-line wasn't as bad as people are going to say. Relax. Parrott gave up a sack, okay? It was ugly. But this is the time to do that. If there's ever a time to do it, this is the time. So I thought the O-line as a whole, the starting unit there and there, was just okay. Sprinkled in moments of not good. So it is what it is, you know. You can't substitute what's been going on in practice for these situations. So it is what it is. It's going to get better. I guarantee it. Now, I wish Kadarius was out there. Defense is good, but we all knew what the defense were. We all knew they were good. But first preseason game in the books. We're getting there, guys. I deleted my Twitter for days like this, but I'm sure they're on there saying the O-line is awful and the Giants will win 3 games this season. Y'all are welcome to join them and worry, but I'm good. You know, I didn't see anything apocalyptic out there. So that's it for me. Thanks, y'all. Peace.